topic, that is under stride, nutritional anemia, right? In nutritional anemia, today we are going to see what is nutritional anemia, okay? Then source of iron, function of iron, then causes of nutritional anemia, iron fortification program, and the disorders related to this nutritional anemia. So what is anemia actually, and what are the consequences of this nutritional anemia and the sources, we'll discuss in detail in this session, okay? And in previous lecture we have studied the malnutrition and overnutrition. In that we have seen the undernutrition and the protein deficiency disorders, that is kwashiorkor marasmus like that, and vitamin A deficiency disorders. But today we are going to see the nutritional anemia, that is related to the iron deficiency. Okay. Now in this we are going to see the basic part of this, as we have already discussed. So what is nutritional anemia? We'll see the definitions and how it develop in our body, we'll see. Then sources, its function, causes, fortification program, and the disorders we'll discuss in detail in this session. So this topic is majorly to understand what is nutritional anemia, the sources of iron, the causes of nutritional anemia, to understand iron fortification program. As we have discussed, this iron fortification or fortification is nothing but the addition of certain minerals or the vitamin externally, right, in the food source, right. Then to understand disorders related to this nutritional anemia in child or in children as well as in adults also. Then we will see or we will know about the deficiency disorders and the treatment for this nutritional anemia. This is not vitamin A, this is the nutritional anemia we are going to see today. We have seen this vitamin A deficiency already. In this session we are going to see the iron deficiency disorders only. So introduction here, this nutritional anemia is nothing but it is of anemia that can be directly recognized through the nutritional disorders. Okay. So what are the nutritional disorders or what are the nutrients? As we have already discussed, nutrients are the micro elements or the micronutrient and macronutrients. So iron is again a micronutrient like that of vitamin A, but the deficiency of these, they can cause a major disorders, okay, that can affect our health, and in later stages that may cause the death also. Okay. So example here, the nutritional anemia is iron deficiency anemia. Then the pernicious anemia, iron deficiency anemia is that can occur in adult phase actually, but in pediatric or in children, this nutritional anemia is the pernicious anemia, we can call it as. Okay. Then according to the World Health Organization of hemoglobin level, so according to this WHO, hemoglobin level in female below 7.5 millimole per liter, that leads to the nutritional anemia. And in male, the level of hemoglobin below 8 millimole per liter, that will lead to this nutritional anemia. So the hemoglobin level should be more than 7.5 in female for the normal life, you can say. Or to prevent the nutritional anemia, the hemoglobin level in female should be more than 7.5, and in male that should be more than 8. Okay. And hemoglobin, as you know, the role of hemoglobin is to carry out or to deliver oxygen in the body, or to carry oxygen throughout the body and deliver the oxygen for the various function to the organ. Okay. Then the respiration defects, if hemoglobin level that decreases, as we have discussed according to this WHO standards, if hemoglobin level decreases in male or female according to their number, okay, so that will cause the respiration defects, okay, because the oxygen is required for the respiration, as you know, and it is provided or it is carried out by the hemoglobin. But if hemoglobin level decreases, then it will reflect into the respiration defects. And that create the adenosine triphosphate, thereby depriving the cell energy. So So what will happen, thereby if oxygen level will decrease, that will also decrease one's or the patient's energy level, right? So, and again one more thing is there, that is folic acid is the common association of nutritional anemia. Okay, not only the hemoglobin, but the content or the another form of this is folic acid. So folic acid is also important for our body or the normal functioning of our body. If the folic acid level also decreases, that will lead to this nutritional anemia. Okay, and the uses of this folic acid, they are required for the pregnant woman mostly for the normal development of the baby in their womb. Okay, so as the signs of this nutritional anemia, so we have seen what is nutritional anemia. Okay, but in this nutritional anemia, the common signs of this nutritional anemia, that is due to the lack of the iron in our body. So the symptoms of this nutritional anemia include, main symptom is cyanosis and jaundice. Okay, but before that, the first symptom that appears due to this iron deficiency is pale skin. Okay, pale skin and yellow eyed person, if you seen, that person may suffer from this nutritional anemia. Remember this. Okay, then in addition to this cyanosis and jaundice, okay, in this figure you can see, this is the cyanosis figure. Here you can see this knee portion or the leg portion is given here, which is showing the reddening and bluish color ulcer like appearance is there. So this bluish color appearance is nothing but a cyanosis. Okay, so that will reflect as a injury. Okay, and bluish or the greenish yellow or sorry greenish bluish coloration is nothing but the cyanosis, and this is the main cause of this iron deficiency and jaundice. But along with this, all another symptoms are also there, like they may experience difficulties with the memory and concentration. Okay, they may lose their memory and concentrate on particular thing. Okay, they cannot concentrate on particular things. Basically, then they will suffer from fatigue, lightheadedness, then sensitivity to the temperature, low energy level, shortness of breath, and the pace. Okay, as we have discussed, they will suffer from the fatigue, that is tiredness, then low-headedness or the light-headedness, okay, like this, and low energy level. This is the main symptom of this iron deficiency. Okay, so here with this help of this figure, you will clearly understand what is cyanosis or it look like. Okay, so cyanosis is defined as bluish coloration or the bluish reddish coloration of skin as well as mucus membrane. So the tip of the fingers or the tip of our toes or where the skin is thin, at that area this cyanosis takes place. Okay, that is the bluish coloration at the tip and the thin layer of skin. So in this figure you can see this baby, see the tips of finger and toes of this baby, they appears bluish in color. So this is nothing but the sign of cyanosis, and that is due to the lack of iron. Right, so it occurs due to the presence of large amount of reduced hemoglobin in blood. Okay, so hemoglobin level in blood is get reduced, or the quantity of hemoglobin is very very less in this cyanosis. So the quantity of reduced hemoglobin, that should be at least 5 to 7% in the blood to cause cyanosis. Okay, when the hemoglobin level decreases below 7, or hemoglobin range is from 5 to 7% in the body, at that condition this cyanosis that takes place. Okay, so the distribution of this, you see what is this, so it is distributed all over the body. So this cyanosis there, that can appear all over the body, but it is more marked at certain region of the skin, as we have discussed, at the deep of the we can say our finger, our toes, and where the skin is thin. Okay, skin, where the skin area is thin, at that region or that portion, that becomes bluish in color. Okay, example, lips, cheek, ear bones, that are soft bones, right? Then nose, fingers, and base of the nail. Okay, so this base or the tip of nail, that become bluish color. This is the cyanosis. Okay, now the symptoms as we are discussing the general symptoms of this again. So the body is unable to adjust the lack of hemoglobin. Okay, so this is the natural phenomenon when hemoglobin level is low, body is unable to adjust that imbalance hemoglobin. Okay, so that may result in shock and death also. Okay, in severe cases, if this nutritional anemia remains untreated, at that condition, the person can suffer from the shock or the finally that will be dead. Okay, or that person will be dead. Then mild and moderate anemia have symptoms that develop slowly over the time. Okay, initially we cannot recognize whether this is the anemia or what. Okay, a person may suffer from the tiredness or fatigue, so he will not understand whether he is having the nutritional anemia. And if it is untreated for long time, then the causes of that will lead to the death. Okay? If patients experience symptoms of anemia, remember this, they should contact the doctor. Or if you are the student, now you know what is nutritional anemia and what are the symptoms. If you see any person from your family also that is having this kind of symptoms, so please convey them to go for the doctor. Okay, and take advice of doctor regarding this. Now here you can see in this picture, this is the severe case of the nutritional anemia disorder. So these disorders are called as a neural tube defects, and they are shortly called as the NTDs. Okay, that is the neural tube defects. So question for your MCQ and for your internal exam that can be asked of this defect, that is the most rare effect you can say. Okay, so neural tube does not form right and the body's brain or spine is damaged. So here what is happening here, the neural tube. Okay, so the neural tube that is basically in the body that doesn't form right and the body's brain and spine is get damaged. Okay, so spine and the brain is get damaged in this NTD condition. Okay, and in the right you can see the anencephaly condition is given, that is forehead is as good as absent. Okay, or that is bended. You can see it. So it happens within the first few weeks of pregnancy, often before a woman knows that she is pregnant. Okay, remember this. If the female is suffering from this nutritional anemia, okay, that is because of lack of iron in her body. Okay, at that condition only her baby can suffer from this neural tube defect, because the folic acid is the most important part for the development of the babies. Okay, and if that woman is not having adequate level of folic acid or iron supplement, that baby can suffer from this NTDs. Okay, and these are the cases of that baby. So here you can see the baby can cause lifelong disability or the death also. Okay, so in this figure you can see the spina bifida of this baby, that is the, you can see the outer or the outwarding of this spina bifida. Okay, that is the open spine, you can call it as. So many NTD up to 70% can be prevented by getting enough vitamin B9, that is folic acid, every day. So it will starting before a woman gets pregnant. Okay, so folic acid supplementation is very important for pregnant mother for the normal development of the spine and the brain of that particular baby. So here you can see the spine or the outward bubble formation of that spine is here, that is only due to the lack of folic acid or the iron supplements. Okay, this is the neural tube defects. Now the iron requirements of our body. Okay, how much iron quantity we require daily, that is given here. So as we have discussed, the iron is the micronutrient or the micromineral. Okay, so adult contains 4 grams of iron. Okay, or the daily requirement of iron or the iron present in our body is 4 grams or around 4 grams you can say. So from that 4 grams, 2/3 of this 4 grams that is present in the hemoglobin. that is 2.4 gram of iron present in hemoglobin, or hemoglobin can convert this 2.4 gram of hemoglobin to our body. But if hemoglobin concentration is low in our body, that hemoglobin or iron which is provided by hemoglobin, that will be again get affected if hemoglobin level is affected, right? So here the chart is given, okay, to understand the requirement of hemoglobin, requirement of iron in milligrams, okay, per day. So male requires iron 0.84 milligram per day. Females require 1.65 milligram of iron per day. Pregnancy or the pregnant women require 2.80 milligram of iron per day. And the lactating mothers or the feeding mothers, they require 1.65 milligram of iron per day. And the next column is the RDA, that is the recommended dietary allowance. Okay. So recommendation from this National Institute for the Indian Government, that is the for male it is 17, for female it is 21, and for pregnant mother this is 35, and for lactating mother it is 21. Okay. So remember this requirement of iron to our body. Then let's discuss some sources of iron. How to prevent this iron deficiency disorder? By taking or by intake of certain iron rich sources. And what are those sources? We'll see some heme iron sources and some non-heme iron sources of them. That is, heme iron will present at the certain of the structure of this source. Okay. So heme iron, they mostly contain the non-veg food. Okay. So non-veg food is mostly rich in iron sources. Okay, or iron. So sources of the iron or the non-veg sources are meat, fish, poultry, and liver. Okay, then they help to absorption of non-heme iron also. Okay, if you take these sources or the non-veg sources of the iron, they can help us to absorb the non-heme iron also. Okay, and again one more thing, that is the milk is the poor source of iron, but breast milk is well utilized. Okay, for the infant, for the baby, the breast milk is the best iron source for them up to the 6 months old. Okay, then vegetables which are the source of iron, that includes cereals, green leafy vegetables, pulses, nuts, dry fruits, jaggery, but its bioavailability is poor. That means they cannot get absorbed easily, but the iron present in this vegetable that cannot absorb easily. Okay. But the iron present in this vegetable, non-vegetarian food or the non-heme food, they get absorbed very quickly. Now again, okay, these are some iron sources you can see here. Okay, so iron sources here, heme iron sources are there. They mainly contain the non-veg food here, and they show the direct absorption. Here in this figure, you can see this heme iron content of the non-veg food that shows the direct absorption of iron. But the non-heme iron that are present in the vegetable origin or the vegetable food, they show the less absorption, but in presence of vitamin A, vitamin C or the Y beta carotene, they show the absorption. That means the non-heme iron get absorbed with the help of vitamin A, vitamin C, and in presence of beta carotene. Okay. So the iron sources, when iron absorbs in decreased quantity or the decreased absorption of iron, that is because of phytic acid which is present in cereals and fiber, and polyphenols in plants, okay, and tannins. And that means if we take cereals, fibers, and plant origin in more quantity, so the iron which we are consuming, that will show the decreased absorption. That's why we have to take this phytic acid or the cereal fibers and plant origin sources in less quantity to get more absorption or to improve the absorption of iron. So these are, you can call it as harmful material for the absorption of iron, that aspartic acid or the polyphenols and tannins also. Okay, and tea also that is also harmful for the absorption of iron. Okay, as the tea or the coffee that contains caffeine, they are again reduces the absorption of iron. Then the sources which enhance non-heme ion absorption, that is heme ion, ascorbic acid, and the low pH vitamin C. Okay, that means in presence of heme ion, ascorbic acid, and low pH of vitamin C, they will increase or they will enhance the absorption of the vegetarian source of iron or the heme non-heme ion absorption. Okay, so enhancement of the non-heme ion absorption, we require ascorbic acid and heme ion or the vitamin C. Okay, then absorption and loss of the iron in our body, we see mostly this iron get absorbed in duodenum part of the stomach. Okay, so the iron in the ferrous state that get absorbed in the duodenum part of stomach, that is, as you know, the part of stomach, duodenum, jejunum, and all. So the duodenal part is basically that is for the absorption of the iron in the form of ferrous. Okay, and once it absorb iron in the state of ferrous, it transfers this ferrous state of iron to the small intestine. Okay, then the absorption of this iron in from the habitual Indian diet is less than 5%. Okay, why is less than 5%? Because Indian diet that contains vegetable or the non-heme iron most of it, right? So the most of the Indian diet that contains non-heme iron or the vegetarian food, so the absorption of that iron is less, and the absorption is less, that means it is around below, or it is below 5% of absorption is there due to the Indian food diet, okay, or the vegetarian food diet. Then this iron, it get transported as a plasma ferritin. Okay, so the state of the iron that is transported to the body or to the various organ, it is in the form of the ferritin. Okay, it is absorbed in the form of ferrous and it is transported as in the form of the plasma ferritin. Remember this also, okay, students. Then it is stored in liver, spleen, bone marrow, and kidney. Okay. It is absorbed in the duodenum, it is transported as a plasma ferritin, and it is recycled in kidney. Okay, as in this figure you can see, as we consume the iron source, it get absorbed in stomach, okay, and it is stored in the liver, then in the blood in the form of plasma ferritin, it in the form of plasma ferritin it uses for the various metabolic processes, and in the kidney it get recycled again. Okay, so this is the main absorption and loss of this iron. And the main thing, okay, what are the main causes or the causes of loss of iron are, first is the hemorrhage. Okay, hemorrhage, that is the internal bleeding, you can say, okay, or bleeding that does not stop. This is also called as a hemorrhage, and the physiological menstruation and childbirth. Okay, due to the menstruation and childbirth in female, heavy loss of blood is there, and because of that heavy loss of blood, indirectly indirectly the heavy loss of iron is there. So this, because of this heavy loss, these females, they suffer from this nutritional anemia. Okay, then the pathological terms, that is the hookworm, malaria, hemorrhoids, and peptic ulcers, these are also main causes of this nutritional anemia. Okay, as where the blood is get lost, right? So when blood is get lost, that indirectly leads to the less hemoglobin, right? So the basal loss of this iron is again through the urine, sweat, bile, and the decarbonation of the surface cell. Okay, so the moderate loss is because of this special things, that is the secretions of urine, sweat, and bile, right? Then functions. Okay, let's see the functions. So they require, or the iron require for formation of hemoglobin and myoglobin. Okay, as hemoglobin and myoglobin, they both require for the transport of oxygen as well as the carbon dioxide. Okay, then constituents of enzyme like cytochromes, catalase and peroxidase. Okay, then for the formation or the production of these enzymes also these ions, iron helps. Then oxygen transport and cellular respiration, as we know, cellular respiration that involves oxygen intake and carbon dioxide exhalation, right? Like that, they help for the respiration. Then cellular immune response and the functioning of the phagocytes. Okay, cellular immune response, that is for the production of antibodies against viral infection, and phagocytosis, as you know, the natural killer cells or phagocytic cells engulf that foreign antigen to prevent body from the external diseases or any kind of diseases. Then it is also important from the brain development and functioning of brain, as we have seen the entities. Entities. Then regulation of body temperature and muscle activity. This iron is very very important. So these are some functions. So students, please remember this function for your math also and for your MCQ test, which will be conducted soon. Okay. Now again, definition of this nutritional anemia. With the help of this figure, you will clearly understand how this anemia looks like or what is the causes of this anemia. Okay, what is the main cause of this anemia? As in this figure, you can see the red blood cells are given here. Okay, so red blood cells in this area, you will see they get saturated here. Okay, and they are not get provided to the particular organ. Okay, so that may cause the organ failing. Okay, when blood that does not get supplied properly to the organ, that organ that may fail. Okay, a condition, now come to the definition. A condition in which hemoglobin content of blood is lower than normal. Okay, as we have discussed the hemoglobin level of male and females also, that is result of deficiency of one or the more essential nutrients, regardless of the cause of such a deficiency, according to the WHO. Okay, so when according to this nutritional anemia, when hemoglobin or the iron level that decreases, that leads to the nutritional anemia, and that is related to the red blood cells also and the iron concentration. Now most IDA, okay, that is microcytic, that is iron deficiency anemia, look like this. Okay, that is the supply of the red blood cell or the supply of blood that get blocked due to the blockage of the red blood cells. Okay, or there is another term, that is sickle cell anemia. Okay, that is again different thing, but that is related to this also because of the sickle cell, that means the moon shaped RBC that appears and that get blocked. Okay, so the blood supply that get blocked and it leads to the failure of organ. Okay, now iron deficiency anemia, again it is less common, that is vitamin B12 and folic acid deficiency. Okay, so this anemia, less common anemia, that is because of the deficiency of vitamin B12 and folic acid. Then it is macro and the megaloblastic anemia also, that is less common because of this B12 and the folic acid deficiency. Then more than 100 diseases may cause anemia, as we have discussed the diseases when we get the anemic condition, but 90% belong to the three groups. Okay, so we'll see what are the three groups of this anemia in later for the in next lecture. So the nutritional deficiency as the iron, vitamin B12 and folic acid, and the chronic inflammation and the tumors also that leads to the nutritional deficiencies. Okay, so as you know, the chronic inflammation, okay, that is not curable, and tumors that may develop into the cancer, and that is fatal also, that will lead to the nutritional anemia. Okay, then bleeding, that is excluding chronic bleeding which produces iron deficiency. Okay, unnecessary bleeding that may also lead to the nutritional anemia. Then here the cutoff criteria in venous blood, that is hemoglobin level according to the adult and child, that is given in this chart. So this chart, you can see the adult man's hemoglobin that should be more than 30. Okay, for adult woman or the non-pregnant or the normal woman, the hemoglobin level should be 12. Then adult women, that is pregnant, the hemoglobin level should be more than 11. And child above 6 years, hemoglobin should be 12. And child below 6 years, the normal hemoglobin level should be the 11. Now the problem of statement is given here about, due to this iron deficiency. So what is the problem we see? So it is more prevalent in women of childbearing age. Okay, that is childbearing age, that is women of 10 to 14 years old, young children, pregnancy and lactation. So these are the groups where we can majorly see the iron deficiencies, okay, or the iron deficiency disorders, right? In India, more than 50% of women and 70% of children are anemic, but not in cities or not in the developing state, but in tribal areas and in some rural areas, we can see this iron deficiency conditions and the symptoms. Right? Then the adolescent girl, that is around 14 to 15 years, right? 72.6% are anemic. Okay, that is the DNHA district level household survey that shows the 72.6% adolescent girl are anemic. That is mainly because of the menstruation. Okay, that is the loss of blood through the menstruation. Right. Now the causes of iron deficiency anemia, that is IDA. Okay, so what are the causes here? So inadequate intake of iron, this is the main cause of this nutritional anemia or the iron deficiency anemia. So that is because of the poor diet intake, okay, due to the poverty, ignorance of the diet and the inadequate folate or the vitamin C intake. Okay, so this is the main cause. Then second is the poor absorption and the bioavailability of iron, and this bioavailability is directly proportional to the absorption of iron. Okay, as we have discussed, the non-heme sources of iron, they does not get absorbed properly until and unless they are having the vitamin A or the ascorbic acid for their absorption, right? So this is bioavailability of iron, that is because of low absorption, that is less than 5%, poor absorption, that is non-heme iron inhibitors, phosphate, phylates, oxalate, fiber, T, that is tannin and calcium. That means if these things like non-heme iron inhibitors are present, they will not allow iron to absorb in our body. Okay? Then excessive loss of iron, that is because of the normal man is 1 milligram per BA or deciliter. Then menstruation, that is around 2 milligram per deciliter, okay, according to the international standards. Then the intestinal worms in case of malaria, that will also lead to the loss of iron. And repeated pregnancies, that will also lead to the heavy loss of iron. As in tribal areas or in some rural areas, there are more than 4 to 5 children per woman. So there is a heavy loss of menstruation, sorry, heavy loss of blood indirectly, the heavy loss of iron is there. Then last is the increased demand of iron, that is in pregnancy and in growth period of child. Okay. So these are some causes of the iron deficiency anemia. Remember this chart also. Then increased risk of iron deficiency. So what are the reasons for developing this iron deficiency? Let's discuss. For women, you can see the growing children and adolescents, okay, if they are not taking proper food, they can suffer from this iron deficiency. Then pregnancy and lactation also, that also affects the iron level. Then heavy menstruation, chronic bleed, hemorrhoids, peptic ulcers and acute gastritis, that will also lead to the loss of blood and indirectly they will they affect the iron concentration. Then iron deficient diet, then strict vegetarians as they contains the non-heme iron, we know, right? Then heavy tea, coffee drinkers, that is tannin and the caffeine is present, that is the inhibitor of the iron absorption. Then reduced gastric acid secretion also, then atrophic gastritis, chronic antacid use, okay. If you are using antacids like Pan-40, Pan-D or anti-acids, okay, whatever you are taking for your acidity, all the tablets you are taking for acidity that are antacids, So the chronic or the excess use of that antacids also that leads to the iron deficiency. Then reduced transport due to the deficiency of vitamin A, vitamin B6 and the copper. Okay, as this vitamin A, vitamin B6 and copper are the inducers, or you can say they help in absorption of iron, right? Then prevention and control here. Right, how we can prevent and control this iron deficiency anemia or the nutritional anemia? That is, for the children you can breastfeed, right? Breastfeeding of this breast milk is more rich source of the iron for the children or the infants, you can say. Then dietary modification, that is the fortification also, that is addition of iron source in our food. Then deworming. Okay, what are the worms are present in our stomach? We can deworm them, we can remove them by taking some tablet or some other treatment also. Then control of infection, any other infection like diarrhea and all. Then supplementation and iron fortification. Okay, as we have discussed, this fortification is supplementation of iron externally in our food. Then nutritional education for tribal people. Okay, how to include iron resources in our diet, that should be conveyed to those people. Then care of pregnant and lactating mother is also a prevention and a technique for the control of this iron. So here in this figure you can see the strategies for prevention of iron deficiency anemia and malnutrition here. So here at upper part you can see the dietary diversification. So in that we can include the various food in our diet which are rich in iron. And food fortification, that is addition of mineral or the vitamins or the iron in diet. Then IFA supplementation with the binomial deworming. Okay, deworming, that is removal of worms from stomach. Okay, because some children, okay, mostly these worms are present in children because they play in soil and soil is a resource of worms. Okay, and also secondly, they provide improved health services. Okay, for improved health services, that means to maintain hygiene and to prevent any kind of diseases, this will also prevent the IDA. Okay. Now the National Nutritional Anemia Prophylaxis Program. Okay, so to avoid or to prevent this iron deficiency anemia, National Nutritional Anemia Prophylaxis Program is there, that is launched in 1972. Okay, so beneficiaries of this program are pregnant and lactating mothers or women and children of 1 to 5 years and women acceptors of family planning. So these are the beneficiaries included in this program. Then target group for this program is infants of 6 to 12 months and school children of 5 to 10 years and adolescents, mostly the girls up to from 10 to 19 years. Okay, so this program is to provide the iron resource, to educate them about the diet and the supplements. Okay, then this program that involves this IFA supplementation program, here you can clearly see what this program actually does. So for children 6 to 16 months, 1 ml of IFA syrup containing 20 mg of elemental iron and 100 mg of folic acid bi-weekly given to these children. Then 5 to 10 years children, tablet containing 45 mg of elemental iron and 400 mg of folic acid is given weekly. Then second, for adolescents, girl or boys also, 10 to 19 years, right? Okay, this is the adolescent year age. So 100 mg of elemental iron and 500 mg of folic acid is given weekly. Then for women of productive age, okay, or we can say the women above 20 to 30 age, they are given 100 mg of elemental iron and 500 mg of folic acid weekly. Right, by this National Nutritional Anemia Prophylaxis Program. And lastly, the pregnant and lactating women or the mother, they are given with the 100 mg elemental iron and 500 mg folic acid daily for 100 days in pregnancy. Okay, then it is followed by the similar dose of IFA supplementation for the 100 days in the postpartum period. Okay, after delivery also they are given with the same news. Okay. So now we have discussed all the terms related to this deficiency, iron deficiency anemia, and for this these are some references you can refer. Now students, this is assignment for you, that is you have to upload on the Google Drive or email, that is amritajadhav@kdhmcollege.ac.in. So that is for your 10 marks. First two questions are there, 5-5 each. First question is, explain iron deficiency disorders in detail, and second, what is the national program for prevention of nutritional anemia, which is launched in 1972. That program you should write here. Now let's summarize the topic. Now what we have studied in this, we have studied what is nutritional anemia, sources of nutritional anemia, function of iron, causes of nutritional anemia of the IDA, then iron fortification program, and the disorders related to the this nutritional anemia, and what are the implications of this iron deficiency problems we have discussed, right? So in the next lecture, we are going to see the iron iodine deficiency disorders and overnutrition.